Hi, I'm Angela Martin and welcome to a very beautiful sparkly day at number 31 Butler Drive in Kuranda. If you have been searching for that magnificent, majestical rainforest property, but you still want enough flat, usable land to develop or build your dream, this two-story romantic Queenslander style property could be exactly what you're after. We're on about 1 acre and we are so easily commutable to Cairns. This is location plus. Let's go in and have a look. You're going to fall in love with it. This is just a brilliant little entrance where you come into the two garages underneath either or, and we'll have a look at that of course. But when you come up the stairs, you've actually got this beautiful natural light out of the elements, out of the rain, and you could just imagine little chairs or plants or little yummy things welcoming you home. So we are going to go in and have a good old explore. After you. There is instant coolness and instant calmness when you come in, and I'm quite warm today. When you come up into the house, you've got elevation, we've got breezes, and of course all the doors and the windows, they just open, you know, so you've got that sense of the garden coming into the house. And I've deliberately left some of the lights off so that you can actually see how much natural light is in this whole living space. So a little bit of orientation, we come up the stairs. We've got a little entrance area there, and then we've got three bedrooms and two bathrooms up on this level. So that's bedroom one, or rooms one, two and three, and that's the master with the ensuite, and that's the family bathroom, as it were. Fabulous kitchen, and we've got a dining room just around here. So let's start with the kitchen. Love the kitchen. Now, brand new dishwasher. Fabulous tiles, and of course wooden, organic, lovely cupboard doors. Plenty of prep space. I just love that. I really love it. It looks clean, it looks sparkly, and it is just so in keeping with this style of house. Got fridge, got gas cooker, and it's even got all like little European-y styles, if you like. I don't know if it's, you know, Dutch or old Australian, but I think it looks fabulous. But come round this side so you can actually see what it would be like to be in here prepping. You can look out your window. I don't know if you can see this, but we have got magnificent, and I mean magnificent, rainforest vista. Nobody looking in. And then if we have a look round here when we're prepping, chopping food, having coffee, having tea, making brekkie. Again, we have got all these windows with the garden rainforest views coming in. It is just sensational. So let's just have a bit of a look through the living area and then we'll head into those bedrooms. I just wanted to let you see how open everything is. So this was little stairs coming up from the front garden, and this is a big spacious room. We've got fans, we've got chiligo marble. Now these tiles, I don't think they make them anymore. They were original chiligo marble, and you could, you know, polish them, cover them, love them, but they are a pretty unique and special product, and it adds a lot of warmth to this whole living area. So we've also got, you know, this could be your living space too, two living spaces. So rumpus, watch telly, or a great big formal dining table as we've got here. But we've got a wonderful little fire, nice nook for the winter. So you could have another lounge here. You could just be sitting, relaxing with a glass of wine or your brekkie morning tea for those cool, chilly Kuranda nights. Not that we get them very often. And then we've got this other magic space. Now, this, when the house was built, this was actually built as the formal dining area, because you can get inside and you can get outside. But as always, they are just rooms, loved rooms, spaces. You can put in them whatever your little heart desires. But again, this feeling of in and out is absolutely magic. And of course, just have a little look up here at that rainforest view. Sparkly sun, it's just beautiful. But again, natural light coming in everywhere. I'm wandering around like I'm about to do a waltz. So we'll have a quick look at the master bedroom, and then we'll look at these other rooms, and then we can pop downstairs and explore. Big, bright, spacious. Again, we've got doors that open up on two. That fabulous little balcony. It's three-way, really. We've got the doors from the dining room, the older dining room, and the lounge. Little setting in there, again, relaxation. It's just, well, actually, we'll have a look because we're here. Plenty big, big space. I don't know how big it might be, but let's just have a little try. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Roughly 25 square meters. So you could get quite a few people there relaxing at the end of the day. So back to the master bedroom. Big room, again, plenty of natural light. Just have a look up at these. I don't know if we can see that in the camera. The Likuala palms, that's those beautiful fan palms that you find in the rainforest. And if you look at the angle of the bed, that's exactly what your view would be in the morning. Now, we've got, you're on ensuite, so just pop your little head, pop your little head in here. Shower, toilet, lovely fluffy towels, and real nice paneling. Plenty of space, walk-in shower base, lots and lots of room. And of course, we've got the frosted glass here. Not that you need it, because there is no one, I guarantee there is no one actually looking into the house. So let's just head back out into the living room. We're going to poke our head into the two other little rooms, then head downstairs. Then we've got this other little office nook, and of course a room that's, again, it could be a bedroom. Just pop your little head in. And then the family bathroom, but this is big, this is chunky. This has actually got wood in it. Not that we need it at about 35 degrees today, but it's all stocked up for next winter. Hopefully we can use it. Then the main family bathroom, just similar to the ensuite, sort of original, completely clean, tidy, functional, and a bit organic with that nice, lovely, warm wood. So if you actually look at the whole layout and the feel of the house, you'll get the sense that everything ties in. You know, we've got the wood in the bathrooms, we've got the wood in the ensuite, we've got the wood in the kitchen, and again, I'm going to go on about it because it is a bit special, the Chiligo marble on the floor. It really is, it gives it character. High set romantic Queenslander with character. So we're going to have another bit of a quick look around here, and then we're going to head downstairs, because what we've seen up here is exactly the same space that we've got downstairs. Heading downstairs into that massive, big, same space as upstairs, but utility beyond belief. Now, when we came in at the beginning, the two sets of roller doors were down, and we actually have little remotes so we can have them up and down, but there's plenty of space for cars. You can get a car in here and probably two or three or four cars, or well, maybe three cars, in here if you wanted to. So plenty, plenty, plenty of space. But check this out. Upstairs, three bedrooms, two bathrooms. Downstairs, flexibility plus, options plus. You could do whatever you wanted to do here, because it's all the same space. So we've got concrete floor. This goes all the way back, so that's the back end of the house. But this has been set up as a commercial Pilates studio. So if you wanted to perhaps run your business from home, you know, this is a classic example of what it could look like. Or you could have it as a home office, or you could have it as a pottery studio, an artist studio, because you get all that ventilation and, again, plenty of natural light. I'm not going to open those two doors yet. Ta-da! I'll do that in about half a minute. So I just wanted us to get a feel for the space. And then this was the other garage door that we came in. So again, you know, you can, like all houses in far north Queensland, you can actually get into the house lots of different ways. So again, concrete floor, plenty of space. We've got a little hot water service here that you can see. And then this is the laundry. So the laundry also has a separate toilet in it. So if you're down here sleeping in that little rumpus area that we'll just have a quick look at, we've got access to a toilet, so really, really handy. Just have a little look in here. It's actually a big toilet. And then all the functionality of spacious. I'm not a big person. Not a little person either, but you know, there's plenty of space. So we've got double laundry tub. Again, those sorts of things are normally unheard of, and I know it's a bit utility, but when you're doing stuff, having two stainless steel sinks is really, really handy. Let's close this little door here, a little bit of privacy. And then the rumpus room, I call it rumpus room because it's a big room, and it takes us out to the back section here, which we'll go out and have a look at it in a minute. But it's got an air conditioner in it, and you could use it, you know, for an extra sleeping area, or again, it's a brilliant big room under the house and absolutely mega cool. These two little doors here both lead out to, whoops, that's how breezy it is, under here. Now I hear you say, what is under here? Well, it's under here. That was the little deck that we had upstairs. And we've got the same undercover space here. Now, my imagination runs riot when I see little special spots like this, because again, it is cool. We have got a really hot day today. We're getting breezes coming through. We're on a concrete slab, and that is a very own fabulous rainforest view. And the other quick thing that I have to remind me to tell you is three-phase power. So if you have to use, you know, heavy-duty machines or anything like that, not that you probably would, we actually have that here. And we've also got solar power, around about 3.5 kVA. So power bills way lower. But that's just magic. Absolutely magic. So just breathe that in, and we're just going to have a quick walk around the garden before we do a wrap up. Isn't that just the most sparkly fan palm? That's the one that when we weren't actually lying in bed, but that's the view that we got from the master bedroom. It's gorgeous. These take a long time to grow. These are old palms. They are slow growing. So that's been there at least, I don't know, probably 20, 30 years, maybe even longer. But what I wanted us to have a quick explore, because we said at the beginning, a rainforest property, commutable to Cairns, but we've still got enough flat usable land, and you can see that the land has been recently sculpted and ready just to, you know, redo whatever you want to do with it. But we have flat, clear land around about the house, which is brilliant. But we have also got our own natural rainforest. So the land's about an acre, roughly 4,000 odd square metres, and about a quarter of it is at this front end. Walk around the house, easy, kids can come out and play, or you can just relax. And we've got about 100, 150 metres in that direction where you could walk up through, you know, your little tracks, make little tracks, go explore, you'll find butterflies, you'll hear bird song, everything. But this down here is magic because we've got a seasonal creek, and somebody's lost their truck. I wonder if it'll ever be found ever again. Come down here, because this, A, it's just like little fairy magic spot, but look at that. Just look at the buttresses on that tree. And we've originally had some sort of fence where maybe, you know, children or a dog. And then we've had these remnants of steps that have gone down to the seasonal creek. So we're gonna come down here. And the imagination is just fabulous. Look at this, look. That's real. I always remember David Attenborough, hi David, how are you? Saying that far north Queensland was one of his most favourite spots in the whole wide world. And I'm sure when he made that point that he was referring to phenomenal, just marvellous trees like that. Anyway, moving right along, we're not going to go all the way down here, but we can see steps, little bits over there where there was clearly a little Trumbull bridge, and you can imagine the water going through there again in the wet season, and the sparkly sun, you're going to be way cooler, sitting here, having a cup of tea, doing your yoga, and then just little bridge over, and then up another 100, 150 metres into your back garden, nature's own resort. Absolutely phenomenal. So we're going to have a bit of a quick wander around the site of the house, and we're going to do a wrap up. And the other yummy little thing about this rainforest property is that there's all these little secret hideaways, paths through. Whoa, look at that. That's pandanus, and they are stunning, stunning plants. This is magic. This is absolutely magic. Again, you can feel the temperature drop. Now, we are just coming into a little, it's just a little whence upon, it's a little magical area. And just have a look over here, because this is where the creek will come through. Again, look at this. This is fabulous, absolutely fabulous. And I go on about the temperature dropping because the rainforest is a natural air conditioner. So you could be blazing hot out there if you want to put in your new swimming pool and relax in the sun. And then you can just for, you know, the end of the day, just have a little seat here, little table, chairs, or especially down the back or over the other three quarters of your acre rainforest at the back, just to cool off and just to enjoy and just to be. Brilliant, absolutely brilliant. We're going to head up, have a quick look at the front gardens, and then I promise we're going to do a wrap up. So we've got all these lovely little rainforesty nooks, but I wanted to bring us back out to the front of the property so that you can just see how much space we've actually now got. And this, if you wanted to put in a swimming pool, I think would be the best spot. We've got, again, that look at that tree. Just look at it. It's just, again, we live in the rainforest and all the natural beauty. And little, again, pathways that go up and through, just waiting for you to explore. But if you put a fence up here, so like, ooh, you can't see me. We've got a fence up here, right up there. So basically, we leave the two driveways open. You would have the most magical 100% private oasis. And hopefully, you can get a sense of just how big and open and spacious that house is, with all the flexibility that it affords. You know, cars, solar, 4 bedrooms, 2 bathrooms, easy walk into Cairns. No, you can't walk into Cairns, it's an easy drive into Cairns, so you could happily commute. And we are on Butler Drive, which is one of the dress circle properties at the top of the range estate. So if there are not enough reasons to give me a call, I am not sure what else I can offer you. This is absolutely fabulous, brilliant value for money property. So do give me a call. Angela Martin, 0403-788-187. Visit the website, AngelaMartin.TV. And if you want to see more fabulous properties just like this one, don't forget to press that notification bell or subscribe to the channel. I look forward to catching up with you and sharing your new home.